Hey everyone, this is Erica Rhodes with Maximo TV here in Hollywood, California for the premiere of Carmel by the Sea. Stay tuned as we get some interviews with some of the cast members as well as some other actors who showed up for the premiere. You're watching Maximo TV. Can you tell us a little bit about your character?
Yeah, he's a young guy who is from Carmel. He's a surfer. He's cocky, but he's a good guy at heart. You know, he's a good older brother to Hayden Panettiere. Besides that, you'll see everything else you need to know in the movie.
Okay, keep us hanging. So what happened to your hand, I have to ask?
Motorcycle accident.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
It seems like you've had a lot of love on it.
Yeah, I got a bunch of idiot buddies who, you know.
Cool. Well, we're excited about seeing this film.
Yeah, I'm excited to be here.
You played Bernie in this film. Can you tell us a little bit about your character?
Well, Bernie is Alfred Molina's sort of kind of friend, almost in some ways like a butler. He's sort of, you know, in that old kind of old school way that you have someone who helps you out, and he kind of helps out at his art gallery, and he knows a lot about art, and in some ways he's a bit sort of, we would call posh, a little bit sort of, he looks down at people, you know.
So you're part of the villain squad in this movie.
Well, we shall wait and see.
How excited are you to actually see the final film of Carmel by the Sea?
I'm really excited because normally I kind of insist on seeing a movie before, but this one snuck up and I forgot, so I haven't seen it, which is really exciting to actually sit there. I'll get my popcorn and actually watch a movie, you know.
She's a social worker, Dina Eastwood is the main social worker working with Josh Hutcherson's character, and we're kind of helping find the jewel in this rough kid, and it's really it's a really kind of incredible tender part, and
How was it working with Miss Eastwood?
Oh, she's amazing. I mean, she is the kindest, hardest, she's the kindest heart person I've ever met. And she's just, to work with her is so easy. We sat down and did a scene together and it's like we had known each other for 10 years. So it was just, she's lovely.
And how different was this role from your role on Gossip Girls?
Oh, well, night and day. I mean, New York socialite and Carmel social worker, they're very, very different parts.
I'm supposed to be a rich Middle Eastern guy who loves art, and I go looking for expensive, rare art to buy. So I found this guy that he has art, but we find out later on it was something else. So you'll see in the movie. I'm not going to burn the movie right now.
So you work closely with Alfred Molina then?
Yes. And Molina, I did a lot of scenes with him. I had the honor to do to work with Lauren Bacall. She's a legend. She's a legend. I mean, when you are with a legend, it's like, you know, wow, you know, it's her and Humphrey Bogart, and you know, that's beautiful. Carmel is gorgeous, beautiful. The people are beautiful. They donated their time for the film. I mean, they brought their beautiful clothes and their beautiful personality. And if they didn't pay me nothing for the movie, I would have done it because I had a great time.
You have a role in the film. You play Aaron, right?
Yeah, very. I have a little scene. It was nice. I think I was there on set one day, and they were like, you know what? Go for it. Why don't we throw you just in here? Just, you know, make some trouble. So I did. I pushed Josh Hutcherson, and it was fun.
Get it. Yeah. So how was it working on a film with your sister?
We did one film before. We did a Disney Channel film called Tiger Cruise. And it's always fun working with my sister because I get a lot of my acting from her and from my mom. So it's really nice working with someone who's in the scene who can really help you out. And I feel very comfortable acting around her. So she really brings out the best in me. And because I'm her brother, I think I kind of bring out the best in her, which is nice.
I play Bryn, who is the mother of the lead character, the boy, Josh. And a woman with a troubled life. She's a drug addict and just a troubled person. Not the best mother for her son, and is a big part of the root of his journey. Why he's searching for himself. So that's.
How did you prepare for this role?
I met with people. addicts. I sat in on some meetings that were, you know, I don't know if I'm allowed to say what the meetings were, but they were Narcotics Anonymous meetings, and listened to a lot of stories, read books, watched a couple of really powerful films that depicted characters with a similar background.
Carmel by the Sea is an incredible little film. It's a tiny independent film shot in the town of Carmel by the Sea, but there's some very unique things about it. We've got Lauren Bacall, who's an all-star Hollywood legend, Hayden Panettiere, a very hot Hollywood it girl, Josh Hutcherson, oh, and her little brother. He's in the scene there, too. And, no, we had an incredible cast for the movie, and also, too, it's one of the only international art forgery movies that's been made in the past 30 years, so it's a very unique film in that regard.
How did you come by directing it?
Well, I created the project, raised the money, and put the whole thing together, and created it for me to direct. I've been directing since I was 19. I used to make snowboard movies, did lots of music videos, so this has been a lifelong dream for me to do this.
How did you all assemble this amazing cast?
Well, I mean, you know, we had an amazing story. We started with it's the classic Hollywood tale. You start with an amazing story, you add an amazing, spectacular location, and you can attract really top tier talent, which is I think what happened with this particular film. We were able to secure the legendary Lauren Bacall. I mean, you can't really top that, to be honest. And Alfred Molina does a spectacular job. He really is a force on screen. Josh Hutcherson is as strong as ever. He's a very young talent, but everybody knows him. He's a very, very good actor. And you know, you have Hayden Panettiere as his love interest, and it's a wonderful combination. It plays really well on screen.
I just got attached to a film, Prince of Providence, so that's really exciting. Ed Burns, Robin Williams, Oliver Platt. Super excited. It's going to be filmed in New York. Yeah.
Awesome. So how do you feel about working with them? Those are some pretty big names.
I'm really nervous, but really, really excited. I'm sure I'm going to learn something. I mean, David Mamet wrote the project, so Oscar award winner. So.
What's the film about?
It's about the mayor of Providence back in the day. So he was pretty much a rock star. Yeah. So they're going to show him in the colored light.
What's up? You're here at the Carmel by the Sea. Okay.
I'm here to support Hayden. I did a film with her a long time ago, so I'm out, you know, hopefully see what she's still doing.
Awesome. And your last film, Prayers for Bobby, what was it like working with Sigourney Weaver?
Wow, that was amazing. I mean, what can you say about it? It's Sigourney.
Yeah.
I mean, enough said, but no, she was amazing. What's crazy is everyone's intimidated by her because, you know, she's this extremely powerful, tall woman. But what's funny, what most people don't know is she's actually hilarious. Like, she's, you know, sort of a, I don't want to say a clown, but she's extremely funny, does a lot of pranks, and every day on set, like, you know, it was a very dramatic, serious film. There was definitely times where I had to take myself away because listening to her stories would just take me out of it, and I just, like, I gotta walk away.
Now, you said pranks. Did she ever pull any on you?
No, thank God, no. No, because, like I said, it was pretty serious. Most of the times when I was on set, my character, it was, you know, I was playing a pretty dramatic role. So she, you know, respectively left me alone. No, thankfully she didn't do anything where, you know, I was in a dramatic scene and tried to make me laugh, but no.
The movie called Sinbad the Fifth Voyage, opposite Patrick Stewart and Shaheen Chan Solomon. It was my first film to be filmed all in green screen. It's going to come out July 18. It's a brilliant film, and I'm very excited. I just found out 2 days ago with Shaheen Chan Solomon, the director. He actually, matter of fact, get the editor of Crash of the Titans. So I'm really excited. It's going to be huge. And of course, I was so thrilled because last week I was the first Middle Eastern to be submitted for the Image Award for Green Zone Best Supporting Actor.
Awesome.
Thank you. So I'm really excited, and I just want to give a big thanks for the director, Paul Greengrass. He fought so hard for me for the film, and of course Matt Damon and Universal for submitting me, and there are lots of things coming up.
I know you can't really talk about it a lot, but...
I had a part in the first, second, and third of the character Giselle, who's always slapping Johnny Depp, and there's something special that I can't really talk about, that maybe a bit more of that character coming.
Okay. How was it working with Johnny Depp?
I mean, like, best job ever. It doesn't get much better than that. He's an incredibly sexy man, and also kind and humble and intelligent and funny. He's truly a good fella.
Thank you so much for being here with us at the premiere of Carmel by the Sea. I'm going to go see the movie, so we will see you next time. Right there.